Friends, here we are going to discuss about how to transfer a file using Ansible ad-hoc commands. So simply assume that you are having Ansible engine here and you are going to manage some number of nodes using that Ansible engine. Now our task is you have some file on your Ansible engine and you need to transfer that file or you need to copy that file from your Ansible engine to your required nodes, maybe all nodes or maybe some of the nodes. But be clear, we are not copying a file from one node to other node. So this part we'll discuss while working with playbooks. For timing, we are going to transfer a file from your Ansible engine to your required nodes. And that we are going to achieve using your ad-hoc commands. So guys, finally, what is our task? Transfer a file. So we know that in Ansible, for each and every task, there is a separate module. Now for your requirement, for your task, there is a copy module. Now you can transfer your files using copy module. Now before going to see about your copy module, let me show you once again our simple basic ad-hoc command syntax. Already we have seen this in our previous videos, right? In case if you want to work with any other inventory, then you have to mention hyphen I with your inventory file. But if you want to work with the default inventory, which is there in your ansible.cfg file, at that time, you don't need to mention your inventory file location, right? So simply Ansible, some servers or groups or combination of servers and groups, then hyphen M, your required module, then hyphen A, for this modules, whatever the arguments you are having, you have to mention that arguments. Right? Fine. Now let me show you the simple syntax for your copy module. So simply Ansible, your required group from your inventory file, hyphen M, copy module, hyphen A, arguments. So here I have taken source and destination arguments. Why we need this source and destination means you are going to transfer or copy a file from your Ansible engine to respective nodes or required nodes. So whenever if you want to copy or transfer a file, you should have some source and destination. That's why you have, as of now, simply source and destinations are the arguments for your copy module. And anyway, before going to use this, just go to Google, right? Simply type copy module. Then you are going to get a URL. Just observe the very first URL, that is from official documentation. Just click on that and go through that, this entire page once. Okay, and at the last, you are going to have some playbooks as well. So as of now, we are not going to work with playbooks. We are going to see only your ad-hoc commands. See, we have different parameters here. If you observe here, just go to top, parameters, attributes, backup, checksum, content, decrypt, destination, directory mode, different. These are all arguments actually for your copy module. For timing, I'm going to use some of them so that you'll get some idea. First of all, let me open my Ansible engine. Let me enter into our practice directory. Just let me open my inventory file. So in my inventory, I have three servers with two groups. First of all, let me check it whether they are reachable over the network through your Ansible or not. So simply Ansible, all means all is the default group. If you mention simply all, your Ansible engine is going to work with all the servers which are there in your inventory. Guys, now I am not using hyphen I your inventory file location because I want to work with the default inventory file which is there in your ansible.cfg. See what is there in ansible.cfg? In the current location, whatever the host is there, from that my Ansible is going to pick my servers or groups. Now anyway, let me run this Ansible all hyphen M ping. So all servers are able to reach through the network, right? Fine. Now, let me run your simple Ansible copy module. So I want to transfer a file, right? See how I'm going to do that, Ansible. So let me take cat. So we have two groups. First of all, let me take only one group. So what I am doing is, Ansible I want to copy some file to my DB servers. So let's say DB hyphen M copy module, then hyphen A arguments. So you have to mention your arguments inside of quotations. So better practice is always double quotations. Now let me mention source. Source is in the current location, simply whatever the host file you are having, you can transfer any file. So I'm taking in the current location, whatever the host file is there, that file I want to transfer to my nodes, which are there in this group. But what is the destination on my node? I'm taking simply temp. So if you mention a file, your content is going to copy into that file. If you don't mention with this name, it will copy a file into this location. So let me run this first and see the output. I'm running. Yes, observe the output. Change to true. Destination, see that with this host file, it is going to copy the content, whatever it is there in the host file. Simply your host file copied to temp location. Right? Suppose if I want to create on your remote node or on your nodes with some other name, then I can mention, suppose, different file name. Now see that. If you mention a file name, then it is going to copy your required file, source file to destination with the, your required name. If you don't mention, then into that directory, whatever the name you are having on your source, same name will be created on your remote server. That's it. Now let me enter into your managed node. So simply we have passwordless authentication. I'm entering SSH, then your remote server IP or node IP, then we are entering into that. Let me move into temp location and see that we have host and inventory. Just come out from here. And here I want to show you one more thing. I want to rerun this. Now see the output. Changed false. Destination is, anyway, you are providing your destination. But changed false means this is not changing any content in the destination location, in the destination file. What is the reason? See, just now we copied our file into your managed node. Again, we are trying to copy. But before going to copy, is there any modification in the source file? No. If there is no modification, why should we copy again? So even though if you try to copy the same file once again, your Ansible won't allow that, because your Ansible will able to find that already same content is there in the remote location file. That's why it is going to skip that. So this is one of the property of your Ansible that is called idempotent. So idempotent means if there is no change, then your Ansible won't do that task. If there is something, if some changes are there, then only it will perform your task. Now what I am doing is, let's say in our inventory file, I am going to add localhost as well. Now there is a change, right? Now if you try to copy your, or if you try to transfer your file, now it will copy or it will transfer your file to your remote server. See that? Change true. Right? So whenever if there is a change, then only your content will be copied or your file will be moved to your remote server or managed node. Right? If it is very first time, definitely it will copy. But whenever if you are rerunning, so while rerunning, your Ansible will find the information about your previous state and the current state. If both the informations are same, then it won't do any execution. That's it. Right? Fine. Now, this is one way to use your copy module. So source we have in your hand and we are copying that. But assume that, let me remove all my arguments. I don't have a file, but I want to copy, I want to create a file on remote server with some content. Then you have one more argument called content. Now let's say your content is, hello, this is from copy module. That's it. So content just mentioned in single quotations. Because already we use double quotation, no? Now just use different quotations here. Then what is the destination? So in the destination is nothing but if you don't create now, if you don't use any file now, it will give an error because this is not a file name, this is a content, right? So previously we ran our commands without giving your destination file name and after giving some destination file name. But in that case, source is a file. But now we are not using source, we are using in place of source some content directly created with this information in your remote node, some file. But I'm not giving any file name, no. I have given simply temp location. Not only temp location, you can give any location, but make sure that is exact path. Now let me run it. You're going to get an error. Cannot use the content with a directory as a destination. That's why if it is a content, you need to mention your file. Suppose I want to create hello.txt. Now run that. Now in destination, it is going to create hello.txt file with this content. Just verify that. Just log into your remote server. I mean manage node, then enter into root temp. Now see the content in this. That's it. Right? Fine. So now let me come out from here. Sorry. So now just now we came out from your manager node. Now if you observe in your documentation, right, we are having different options. Let me go with the one more option. Suppose I am trying to copy a same file to your manager node, which is there already in the manager node, but this time content is different. But before going to copy, I want a backup of my previous file, which is there in your manager node. Right? Now you can take a backup. So let me take, suppose. So already we have some hello.txt on your manager node, right? That's why what I am doing is just I am modifying the content. Simply this is from, see that I'm modifying the content. But if you run your previous file, whatever you have, hello.txt, in that whatever the content you are having, that content is going to remove and new content is going to add into that file. But I need backup for my previous file if there is some file with hello.txt. Then simply write backup equals to yes. This is one more argument. Let's say let me enter. Now it is going to show you that change true. And what is the backup file? In the temp location, hello.txt with your timestamp, it has been taken a backup. So if you want to verify that, just enter into your manager node. Go to temp location. Now see that it has been created backup before copying new content to your hello.txt file. So if you want to see that, just see that content. So this is previous file content. Now we have been created this new file. That's it. Okay. So guys, this is the simple way to use your copy module to transfer a file from your current location, I mean from your Ansible engine to with your remote nodes, required remote nodes. If you want to copy same file with your all servers, then you can use simply all, right? And one more thing, see, for time being I have taken root to temp, but I want to copy, suppose I want to create a new file with some content on my user home on the remote node or on my managed node, then what you can do, simply Ansible, let's say db group I'm taking, but you can provide number of servers or number of groups or combination of servers and groups with colon. If you remember, you can provide in this way, right? So as of now, I'm going to take only simply db group. I want to work with db group servers. Now let me copy hyphen a content. This is for db servers. Then destination. So our destination, I want to take, suppose, let me take remote server destination. I can assume home and admin, because we are going to work with ansadmin, right? So in the remote server also, under this location, under this location. So I want to create any file name, let's say demo.txt or db.conf file. That's it. Now let me enter. So as of now, I am going to work with only one server, but you can work with a number of servers based on your requirement. You can copy the content, or you can copy a file or transfer a file with your managed nodes from your Ansible engine simply by using copy module. Right? Now it has been created under your remote server in this location with db.conf. Just enter into your managed node and just verify that. So you are under your user home in the remote server managed node. Just ls. Yes, there is a db.conf file. This is for DB servers. Right? Fine. Now, see, if you observe your information, always you are getting your terminal also in the same line after displaying your content. But I want to enter this in the next line, right? So that's why what you have to do is, so where we have on the remote node, manage node, let's come out from here. Just in the content at the end, just write slash n. Now see that. Yes, change true means it has been changed. Let me enter into remote node. Now see the directly your content information. Now your terminal is coming to next line. So be clear, whenever if you're copying a content, so in your content at the end, just add slash n. Slash n means new line. That's it. Okay. So guys, likewise, you have different parameters here. So what is the group you want to give for your copied file, right? What is the mode you want to provide? What is the owner you want to provide? So you have so many things here. So there are some sample playbooks which are using by copy module. Anyway, we will discuss about these playbooks later. But if you want to see some of the parameters, they are using some parameters, right? So all those things we will discuss effectively while writing playbooks. So for time being, just to get some idea, we are going to use this simple way of your copy module, right? Okay, guys, thank you for watching this video.